let me just to back to these questions then. If you understand that context is important, can you explain to me why it is that you seem to scorn, you seem to sneer at contexts that are willing to give a personal, relational answer?
I just think the arguments have, like, for example, those fallacies, like the God of the gaps kind of thinking, and the other one is the argument from ignorance. There's a whole bunch of logical fallacies that people can use. You basically, when you do deductive reasoning, you have a premise, and you go to a conclusion. And sometimes people use logical fallacies to get there. And so I think one of the big fallacies used over and over again is called this argument of ignorance. That's one of them. There's some other ones too.
Okay. Do you believe in brute facts?
Yeah.
Okay. Can you explain to me why it is that you believe in brute facts?
Well, do you want to give an example of what that is?
Well, I mean, as I understand it, a brute fact stands alone, and without any kind of prior human thought or consideration of it, it remains true. And without any inference or explanation about it, it is there, and I can see it without any prior thought or any following conclusion. I can readily see that it's a brute fact.
So are we talking about something like Chad is sitting in that chair?
Yeah, or like I exist, we exist, that might be a brute fact. Let's try to get like a brute fact.
Well,
like
let's
I
do
exist.
Something much more simpler, because there's too much philosophy there. There's too much existentialism there. How about just taking that hymnal that's sitting right there in that chair?
Mm-hmm. Right. Yeah, so we could say, yeah, we could call that a brute fact without trying to prove it.
Well, the fact would be that there's a hymnal on that chair.
Mm-hmm. Right. We can take that as a brute fact. Right. It may not be there, but it may be a dream. This may not be real. There's all these other things, but we're not going to go there. We're just going to say it's a brute fact. And so we say, that's a brute fact, and let's use that to.
Yeah, see, actually, that's not how I understand brute fact. I'm not talking about the existence of it. I'm talking about how I can make a propositional statement about it. And is my propositional statement about it a brute fact?
I think just saying that it exists is a brute fact.
But I didn't say that it existed, did I?
Well, if you say it's green, that's a brute fact. I mean, I'm not sure.
That would be easier for me. Yeah, yeah. So, when you see that there, does a thought come into your mind?
Sure.
And look at that there, and what may be a thought that comes into your mind?
That it's a book, it's got white pages.
Right. And you don't know it's a hymnal, perhaps, right?
Right.
Right. But I do, and why would I know that that's a hymnal?
From experience.
Right. So, I have some prior thoughts, and I even have prior experience, which means that I come up with a proposition that is significantly different than yours.
Right. Because you have a different fact base, yes.
Right. Mm-hmm. So when I say there's a green hymnal sitting on that chair there, is that a brute fact?
Is that a brute fact?
So is your point, Nathan, the fact that there's a difference between you're saying there is a green book on that chair, which does not require, doesn't require prior knowledge, but to say there's a green hymnal on that chair requires some prior knowledge to know that it's
actually. Actually, I'm trying to find a way to find out if Bernie really believes in brute facts, in independent existing facts apart from anything I think, perceive, experience, or anything that I infer, explain, or conclude. That's what I'm asking.
Well, I think all facts come from experience. You can't know, I mean, in order to have a fact, you have to know about it. So
when we now cook this up to infinity, and we start talking about infinite regress, then we have no experience after a certain point.
Experience.
That's right. And we have, at a certain point with infinite regress, we even lose observation.
You know what?
And we even lose thought.
The thing about an infinite regress, usually they say, because of that, there must be a time zero or when time started, the Big Bang. I don't have a problem with that. I think with multiverse theory, you still have that. Time could have been created with multiverse theory. So I don't see a negative regress as a problem.
Okay, well, we've had Bernie for 10 minutes and Nathan for 10 minutes.